The charter has a checkered history. The country's Chamber of Mines maintains that there wasn't enough consultation before it was gazetted, so they took legal action.
Certainly the temporary solution of the charter being suspended, though, was very important for the chamber. Because, I mean, we've already seen the kind of harm that this mining charter has had on the industry. So it was very important for the chamber that it at least be suspended, even temporarily. Because when we go to court for the interdict, we want the charter to be suspended for an even a longer time, pending the actual review of the mining charter.
The labour unions take a different view, especially when it comes to transformation of the sector. They're disappointed because they believe everyone was consulted.
Where we are standing, the minister was clear that they have consulted more than 15 times to the Chamber of Mines, and they have consulted more than 60 stakeholders on the document. And from where we are sitting, the document should have continued to be implemented.
The miners, though, have a different view.
This charter is not going to be advancing transformation. So the suspension of the charter does not suspend transformation in the mining sector. Transformation continues, and it continues at a pace. I mean, look at the recent transaction by Seriti Resources. That's a 79% BEE-controlled company buying some of the Anglo assets.
That's on the business side, but the NUM says it's about more than that.
Transformation must happen today, and employees and communities have to be part of that particular agenda.
On an investor level, the suspension may present opportunities.
Those who stay and ride the wave through junk, through recessions, it's been proved that you find cheap assets and they could prove fruitful when the business cycle turns around, which it will, even for SA.
While the charter has been suspended for now, this is only the start of a very long legal process that could take months and months to resolve. I'm Angelo Coppola for CGTN in Johannesburg, South Africa.